Have you ever given a thought to where exactly the message goes from your WhatsApp when you hit send? Chances are that you are using Wi-Fi at this very moment to watch this video. How does it get into your device so seamlessly in real time? How does this magical thing known as Wi-Fi work? Welcome back to THOUGHTCTRL, and today we are going to tell you how Wi-Fi works. Imagine for a minute that all the wireless connections in the world have been replaced by cables. You won't be able to even walk without tripping over them. That is the power of wireless. It unclutters our life. Wireless technology started as a way out to send audio programs through the air in the form of radio waves. Then pictures were added to the mix and TV was born. Computers and internet took a longer time. Remember those dial-up modems? Today, over 80% of people use wireless technology to access the internet. Wi-Fi has made internet more handy and practical. But how does it work? Let's steer back a little bit. Radio waves are essentially electromagnetic waves, and electromagnetic waves are basically fluctuation in the electromagnetic field. Radio is a game of throw and catch. Just that instead of the ball, you are sending information coded in the pattern of electricity and magnetism. Let's get back to the original question. Where does the message go when you press send on your mobile? When you press send on your screen, you send instruction to your mobile through tiny copper wires on the circuit board in the form of electrical impulses, which are just electrons flowing through the circuit. So how do the electrons flowing through the copper wires turn into electromagnetic waves in the air? Well, as we said earlier, in order to produce electromagnetic waves, you have to create fluctuation in the electromagnetic field. And this is what an antenna or transmitter is for. Electrons flow in the antenna in carefully choreographed rhythmic dance, like a pebble thrown in the water creates ripples around itself. The electrons flowing in the antenna cause fluctuation in the electromagnetic field around it and emit out oscillating electromagnetic waves that beam through the air at the speed of the light. The wireless router receives the fluctuation, turns them back into electric signals, and sends the information to the internet using physical wire Ethernet connection. The same happens with your friend. His Wi-Fi router receives the information through the Ethernet connection, which then performs the electron dance, emitting the information of message in the air. The antenna of your friend's phone feels the fluctuation and again turns them back into electric signals, which then decoded for your friend to see. And all of this happens in fraction of seconds. Wow! How is that even possible? Well, Wi-Fi transmit and receive data in the gigahertz range.
Hertz is a unit of frequency. Imagine that you are sitting on a beach watching the waves come in. The number of waves coming in within a second or a minute would be its frequency. So if there is one wave coming each second, the frequency of the waves will be 1 Hertz. Now just imagine, if 1 million or 1 billion waves are coming in each second, can you?
I cannot. Wi-Fi's frequency happens to be 2.4 GHz and 5 GHz. And just to clear up a popular misconception, these electromagnetic waves are non-ionizing radiation.
So no, they do not cause cancer.
But recently, treated swimming pools. Dobara karna hai thoda la. Headaches. मैंने गलत बोला ना headaches. थोड़ा पीछे कर देना इसको प्लीज. Why all this fuss? देख तो ले कैमरा.
नहीं वो खत्म होने ही आया
वैसे. खत्म हो गया. दबाना बटन.